Soon I will be done with the troubles of this world. Oh, my troubles of this world, troubles of this world.
The Lord is coming, are you?
Good afternoon, everyone. This is 287, and to those of you who are keeping the Sabbath, I hope you're having a happy and a blessed Sabbath. Now, today I'm going to spend just a few minutes speaking about what comes out of our mouth. Now, Matthew 12:34 tells us, "For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh." So Scripture is telling us what's in our heart, our mind. That's what it's talking about, what's in us will come out of our mouth. When we say it, it came from within us because it was in us. There wasn't something new just created when we started to open our mouth. It was already in us. So for whatever reason, the opportunity arose for it to come out. So if we said it, it was in us. So when you get into these contentious situations and then you want to take back these words just as they're flying out your mouth, or claiming that you're under some influence such as alcohol, drugs, or one of the most popular, anger, it's hard to take these things back because it was in us. So we're going to talk about this for a couple of minutes and see what we're supposed to be doing about this. So with that being said, let's get started with The Mouth Speaketh. Now, as I was saying, when we get into contentious situations, arguments, or what have you, these are the times to be extremely focused on what we're saying, because the most damaging things we say are liable to come out at these times. And to try and use excuses such as being under the influence of drugs, alcohol, or the most popular and most often used, anger, they are a futile excuses, because they are just avenues for the enemy to get in and allow you to be and say what you really mean. See, he can only tempt us. So if he provides a route for us to take and we take it and then things happen, it's on us. All the enemy can do is tempt us. It is up to us to act on any temptation. Always keep that in mind. You can't say the devil made me do anything. He offers you a way to do it and you take it. That's where that responsibility falls, back on us as the individual. So Matthew 12:34 reads, and actually I'm going to read 33 with it. It reads, "Either make the tree good and his fruit good, or else make the tree corrupt and his fruit corrupt. For the tree is known by his fruit." We are all known by our character. That's what it's talking about. We are the tree, and the fruit we produce is our character. So we're known by that, be it good or evil. By what we do and what we say, that's how people know us. So it's extremely important to be on the side of producing good fruit. Now, it says that in verse 34, it says, "O generation of vipers, how can ye, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh." So if corruptness, evil, ugly, however you want to view it, is in you, that's what you're going to produce. That's what's going to come out of your mouth. In the long term, you're going to be what you are, unless you work to change these things about your character. This is how people know us. Also, keep in mind, this is not just a spiritual thing. Even man's law doesn't excuse us for the character we produce under any influence, be it alcohol, drugs, or violence. We fall under the law of man when we do these things. If you get angry and you cause injury or pain to someone or even property, you fall under the law, and now you become subject to the punishment under that law. So it's no different than when you do these things under the Father's law. You are held accountable for what you do, and there is no excuse. So with that being said, remember, it's always extremely important to do what we're told in Ephesians 6, 11, and 12. And they read, "Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil." Verse 12, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness of the world, against spiritual wickedness in high places." So we're told, and we have to remember, that we're not battling against individuals and things that we think we are. We're battling against evil, true evil, and wickedness. And we have no strength against that of our own power. We have to rely on the Father. Put on that armor. Put on that cloak. Put on His protection. And let Him guide you and protect you through all these things. So, with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 2Bait7. I'm out.